It was the very witching hour of night that Ichabod pursued his travel homeward. The sky grew darker and darker as one by one the stars winked out their lights. Driving clouds obscured the moon from sight. Never had the schoolmaster felt so melancholy, so utterly alone. And the nearer he approached the hollow, the more dismal he became. Once inside the murky glen, Ichabod's anxiety increased a hundredfold. For now, the forest seemed to close in behind him. Every small detail of Brahm's awful story returned to haunt his recollection.
Mark,